I'm really trying to go for the whole like sexy college professor motif. Cause I feel like whenever you're a professor, a mathematician, or a doctor, you automatically get hot points.
Here we go.
I'm honestly gonna have a photo shoot in glasses like these whenever I write my book and act like I'm smart, studious, literate. I wish I could just wear glasses all the time. I mean, I could if I wanted to, but I just don't. I'm weird. Hey guys, my name is Lucas and welcome to my channel, welcome to this video. But I felt like this video would be a fun one to do. The starting point is charity more than it is shades, but it's shades dealing with charity. So I'm working with this dope company called Glasses USA. Now before you start crying and tears are falling down your face, get over it. It's for a good cause. So as you know, pride is a big thing, especially right now whenever our government is an absolute mess. And Glasses USA is being awesome and they're helping with that. So I'm actually gonna put on a pair. So there's some glasses on the website that have these cool rainbow patterns on them. Proceeds from these pair go to the Trevor Project. The Trevor Project is a super amazing LGBTQ organization. So if you want cool glasses that have rainbows on them and have money from those glasses being sent to an amazing organization for LGBT people, there it is. Bam, there you go, done, sold. Pack it up, ship it out, let's do this. If you wanna get a pair of glasses on glassesusa.com, they start off $48 for a pair. You can also get a free basic prescription with the glasses, or you can just get regular fashion ones. So of course you have someone like me who has like a bunch of glasses right in front of him that he can try on. Their website actually has this thing called a virtual mirror. You just upload a picture onto their website and you can try on any frame to kind of see somewhat how it's gonna look on you. I literally made sure to get these in gunmetal, and this one's more of like a matte color while this one's shiny. But they're still cute, still rocking them no matter what. I'm not usually one for actual sunglasses, but these are cute because they have the rainbow on them. I think I own like 6 or 7. But they have glasses for sports, for fashion, kids, women, men, unisex, designer brands for those who are more designer, thousands of pairs on their website. Now also when you sign up for the site, you're gonna get free shipping and that was a really bad attempt at a drum roll. 50% off your first frames. Per usual, I'm gonna have a discount code because that's what we do here on the internet. Go jump on that down in the description. Now to get to the rest of this video. Recently, I asked you all to send me questions for a Q&A, but a lot of the questions that I was asked had to do with advice. Some of them were kind of popping out at me that had to do with like relationships and friends and awful things that are going on in the world right now, bullying and rude people and tough situations that you have in your life. I typically like to do advice videos, or I like to do videos where I give tips or hacks or something of that general nature. So I'm gonna tackle that today, but I'm not gonna hold back. Here's one thing that really bugs me. I like to think that I am a nice person. I'm very much an observer just because I write a lot. I wouldn't be a writer. Even though I'm very extroverted and I put myself in situations surrounding people a lot. Whenever you're quiet, people might take advantage of that or think you're not that assertive, which I try not to be. So my first advice that I'm gonna give you guys is to not let people treat you lesser than you are. Now I get people asking me all the time what to do with situations of parents who harass them, or people from school who harass them, or people that are sexist or racist or homophobic or transphobic or whatever. But sometimes it also goes beyond that. There will be people in your life that will just treat you horribly for no reason whatsoever. And recently this has been happening to me a lot. And I figured it's something that I need to be addressed, because if this happens to me all the time, I can only imagine what a lot of you go through, or what a lot of people in general go through, because I have pretty tough skin. Yeah, I put myself out there. I have hundreds of thousands of people looking at my stuff, interacting with me. And a lot of the times I get a lot of negative stuff, which I'm going to be doing a video talking about some of the interesting comments I get, but that's for another time. This is just more an encompassing advice. So when people try to belittle me online, I kind of just like brush it off, because I signed up for this. I realized that this is just going to be a part of my life no matter what. At the end of the day, I'm more validated with myself than a lot of these random faceless strangers that don't even know me well enough for their comments to make sense to really bother me. But you'll find in life, no matter where you go, no matter what you do, that there will be people who will disrespect you. You won't know why, you don't know what's going on, but it just kind of happens. So I need you to remember, make sure that you're sure of yourself. Make sure that what you're doing, what you work towards, whatever you do is to make yourself happy and to improve yourself. No matter what people say about you, or what people do to you, or how people treat you, that you're treating yourself good, that you're loving yourself, no matter what you're doing, whatever journey you're going on, even if you have insecurities, don't let other people tell you that. If you're insecure about something, then you work on that personally. That's not their job to tell you about it. That's not their job to point it out. That's not something for other people to make you feel bad about. So don't let people treat you like that. Not only is this gonna be happening from politicians or your parents or complete strangers, this will also happen with people who are supposed to be your friends or people that you're talking to or people that you're dating or people that you wouldn't expect. So what I've learned from living in LA is that nothing is ever really what it seems. So here's another piece of advice. If a lot of people tell you bad things about another person, there are two ways you can go about that. What I do is that I always give people the benefit of the doubt. I don't like to believe rumors, any of like the BS that people try to throw at you, because a lot of the times that stems from jealousy, or it stems from people stretching the truth or lying or spreading rumors that they've heard that someone else made up or whatever. So take it for a grain of salt, kind of just brush it off, because a lot of the times when people are spreading drama or nonsense, it has no substance, it has no value, there's no purpose to it. Like if I had a dollar for every time someone that I've never met has said they've slept with me, or someone on the internet has used one of my photos, or that I've heard rumors about me that are absolutely outrageous, then I would be like a pretty rich man. I've had some of the most ridiculous blog posts written about me, like things tweeted to me, DM'd to me, and you know, you just kind of deal with it. Because that's just the world we're living in. People are assholes, you kind of have to move on from it. Here's the turning point, here's the difference. Whenever a person proves to you that what you've heard about them is correct, then believe it. If someone has a behavior or does something that reaffirms or validates who they are as a person, believe them, 100% sure. I know people, for instance, that several other of my friends absolutely despise. And of course, the first thing I do is just kind of brush it off, because I'm not the type to judge someone for things that I don't know if they're true or not. But if that person shows you that they aren't as good of a person as you'd like to think they are, then believe them. Because the last thing you want is to continue giving them the benefit of the doubt whenever they no longer have the benefit of the doubt. You'll end up getting mad at yourself for it because you say, I should have known better. That's why I'm just kind of warning you now. Which gets on to my next point. Whenever you're talking to someone or getting to know someone, I completely recommend to keep them private. Don't be putting them on social media right away. Don't be introducing them to your friends right away. Like, you keep that on lockdown. Because excluding maybe one or two of your absolutely closest friends, people have their own self-interest in mind. And even people that are supposed to be your friends will not hesitate to go and do whatever they feel like. So if you're really feeling someone, or you really like someone, and you guys are getting to know each other well, and you think that things are going well, still be careful, because until you have them on lock, you don't know what the people around you are gonna be trying to do. Now, I personally don't really even dated anyone seriously in several years. And it's a mixture of the fact that I typically don't like people that often, but on top of that, maybe I'm better off just being single a bit, I guess. Next off, don't believe everything that you see on social media or that you see in people's lives. Social media is a business like anything else. It is a representation of the best parts of people's lives, or even if it's not the best parts, it's the parts that people typically share. Now granted, this isn't saying that social media is horrible or fake, because that's not true either. Just like whenever you meet people in real life, not everyone's gonna share everything with each other. Social media is the exact same way. They put out what they want you to see, and that's it. But on the flip side of that, just because people put themselves on social media does not give anyone else an entitlement to that person, their attention, their time, or anything else. One thing that drives me absolutely crazy is whenever people see me putting my life on social media, or my friends putting their lives on social media, and then thinking that they have an entitlement for attention from us, because that's not how it works. Now, people who follow me, subscribe to me, I love you guys, and I appreciate you guys being interested in me. But at the same time, there are also people who are getting mad at me because I'm not like stripping down naked and doing porn, or will like send me angry, like threatening messages or letters because I'm not responding to their messages that I don't even see, because I don't even check my DMs that often, or demanding things from me that they don't really have a place demanding. That's not good either. And that might seem rude, that might seem stuck up, but at the same time, everyone has their own lives and they have this thing called autonomy. Here's another thing. Just because you're very extroverted, put yourself out online or in life or whatever, doesn't make you self-obsessed, which is like, it's a crazy concept to a lot of people. So believe it or not, in order for narcissism to be actual narcissism, it has to harm relationships with other people or hurt other people. People aren't inherently assholes. I don't think they just kind of get there eventually. But yeah, you gotta watch out for that. Okay, so here's another thing. Stop trying to make everyone happy. It's just not gonna work. It's not gonna happen. People will always be bitter or upset about something or think that they know how to do things better or how you should live your life. Don't worry about that. Don't pay attention to it. Other people's negative opinions of you should not matter, but you still should be trying to better yourself. So take what other people say and take it for a grain of salt. It's something realistically you need to be working on or not. And if it's not, then ignore it, because a lot of people are just haters. It's true. What I've noticed a lot in our society is that people constantly are throwing out their opinions on things and they don't always matter. Now sure, I throw out my opinions on things a lot, but that's one of those things, is that there's a difference between throwing out an opinion and having logic to back it up, or throwing out an opinion and having something of substance with it. But a lot of the times people just say, oh, well, that just sucks. Okay, well, congrats, you think something sucks. You want a cookie for it? There's a difference between backing something up with logic and just saying whatever you feel like and swearing up and down that that's God's spoken word. Doesn't work like that. So believe it or not, a lot of people's opinions just don't matter unless there's something there to back it up. I'm not just saying that we should all ignore criticism, but the reality is that people who often criticize things don't have the type of experience or knowledge in order to be an actual critic. Like, they don't take 8-year-olds and make them movie critics. I mean, granted, that'd be something funny to watch, but it's not substantiated. 8-year-olds know nothing about cinematography or anything about the movie industry. So if like people don't know you and they're over here just like railing about how awful you are, if they have nothing to back it up, then it doesn't matter. Now granted, if you're over here spewing racist, hateful BS, then bam, there it is. They have something to support what they're saying. So that's different. A lot of the times people are in a middle area in their life. Typically you'll have a lot of people that are really hyping you up and saying that you're absolutely amazing at something, and you have a lot of people trying to tear you down and saying that you're awful at something. And in reality, most of the time you're kind of in the middle. I have people all the time that try to like hype me up and give me so much credit that I don't really deserve. But then again, I have other people who just try to tear me down and just don't give me enough credit where it's due. In reality, I'm like right there in the middle. Like, I'm not the best at things, I'm not the worst. I'm not like some holy angel, but I'm not some like evil demon that we can prove at least. You're never gonna be the best or worst at anything. Now, whenever we divide things up into categories and genres and stuff like that, that goes into like a whole different world. And one thing that really bugs me though, is just how many like hateful, ignorant people there are in the world right now. Of course, that's like an extremity. You have a lot of people in our government and a lot of their like ridiculous cult following that just say the most ridiculous stuff and try to do the most evil things. In the US, we're addicted to violence and we're very weird whenever it comes to sex and relationships. Isn't it kind of weird that we're totally down with guns and killing and abuse and decapitation, but like you have two guys kissing or two girls holding hands and oh my God, it's just the most ridiculous thing in the world. It's kind of crazy how we don't really look at it subjectively. Everything's very objective and it's weird, it's just so weird. I don't know, it just gets annoying all the time. Go follow me on Twitter, you'll see me say all kinds of fun stuff. But for this video, just because very recently I've had been people just pushing my button. Why do we go out of our way to say really screwed up racist things, sexist things, homophobic things, betray people's trust, treat people poorly, just be really rude in general? What's the point to it? Even I get like mad, sad, all these various situations. But as all these turmoils are going on at a larger scale and at a smaller one, I think it'd be better if we just focused on improving ourselves and improving our world. So that's kind of what I wanted to say out of all of this. Like, instead of going on the internet and telling someone to like kill themselves or something, go do something with charity or helping other people. Like, we have hurricanes and wildfires going on right now. We have these ridiculously evil things going on in our government that need to be taken care of, that need to be spoken about, need to be fought. You can volunteer, take action, stand up against people that are doing awful things, but overall, work on yourself and work on your own happiness. And I don't know, I've just been frustrated. That's a good way to put it. instead of just like really lashing out in some of the ways that I wanted to, I felt a good way to express myself is to just talk with you guys and talk about things that have been frustrating me, talk about things I've observed, advice that I have about it, and even some of this is more of a rant than an advice anyways. Because like I said, I see myself as a really nice person, so I found some of the things that I said in this to be kind of shady. Some people might not see that, but then again, we just have some really screwed up shady people in our lives right now. But I want to make sure that from now on, that our messages, our drive in life is about just working every day to better yourself and better the world around us. I'm a person and I have a platform and I'm going to do it whether people like it or not. I love you guys so much and thank you if you watched this entire rant, advice, frustration thing that I was doing. Make sure to subscribe to my channel if you haven't yet, if you want to see more videos from me. I have a PO box if you want to send me love letters or hate mail. You can comment down below, give it a thumbs up, a thumbs down if you so wish, because I know people that subscribe me just to do that. Assholes. No matter what, tomorrow is hopefully going to be a better day. Eventually things get better. We just have to work on it, you know? But yeah, make sure to check out the Glasses USA thing down there and everyone that sits here and chills with me and cares about me and my life. I care about you guys too. The overall message is just to not be an asshole. If you would take me for a college class and then give me like a little hot pepper on ratemyprofessor.com, then go and leave a thumbs up or a comment to let me know that you think I'm a pepper. Also better get 5 stars for like easiness. I love you guys to the moon and back. And I will see you next week. Bye, guys.